All right, so in this video, we're going to look at trigonometric functions on kind of a version of the unit circle. It's not quite the full unit circle because sometimes the coordinates they give us aren't actually identified on the basic unit circle. But we can use a version of it that's pictured below. So suppose that we have coordinate x, y is on the terminal side of an angle theta, and let r, which is our radius, equal the square root of x squared plus y squared. Okay, so that's the x and the y that are squared, and that's the radius. So then we can use these trigonometric functions below, because remember, now we've created this right triangle, because I can go straight down to this one and I have a right triangle where this would be the length of y and this would be the length of x, right, if I were to actually picture this right triangle. So now I can use sine, cosine, tangent, and we also have cosecant, secant, and cotangent. So we have our other three trigonometric functions as well. And so we can use this, these basic rules to find our values. So we can divide y by r to get our sine, x by r to get our cosine, y by x to get our tangent, cosecant, that's our radius divided by y, secant, that's r divided by x, and cotangent, that's x divided by y. And if you notice, these are flipped over. They're the inverse of the three original trigonometric functions. So sine and cosecant, cosine and secant, and tangent and cotangent, they are very closely related here. They're just reciprocals of each other. All right, so let's go ahead and apply this. So we have a coordinate 2, negative square root of 5. And that's going to be a point on a terminal side of an angle, okay? So this is our coordinate. So find the exact values of sine, secant, and tangent. So first, find the length of r. We need to know what the length of r is to apply any of those six trigonometric functions. So we have our x squared and our y squared. So 2 squared, well, that's 4. The square root of 5 squared is just 5. Remember, that's not going to be 25. It would be 25 under the square root sign here, but then the square root of 25 is 5, right? So, and we have a secondary square root sign here. So 4 plus 5 is 9, so we have the square root of 9. So now we have our radius, and we can go through and, the square root of 9 is 3. Didn't quite finish my thought process there. So now we can go through and fill in our three trigonometric functions. So sine, that was y over r. You should be able to see this above on your paper. You should have the notes page. I just didn't bring the picture down. I should probably bring it down here so we could see it again. So y, well, that was the negative square root of 5. And r, we just found, was 3. So that is the exact value. By exact value, it means no rounding. It doesn't want you to actually plug this into a calculator and give them a decimal, because you'll have to round the decimal. So exact means just simplify it as much as you can and leave it that way. Okay. So secant, that was r, the radius over x, so now I'm going to have 3 over 2, and that's as simple as I can get. And then tangent was y over x, so that's negative square root of 5 over 2, and again, that's as simple as that one can get. So this is the idea of applying kind of a version of the unit table to find an exact value for the trigonometric functions. I hope that helped, and I will see you in the next video.